saying things people already know out loud is tight.
Get out of my head!
You park in front of your house, I park in front of my house.
This is...
Hey! If you don't stop, I will contact the usher.
What is up, everyone? It's Adam from FWCI. What is this? The game has got an Eminem diss that just came out called Black Slim Shady, and it goes for 10 minutes and 25 seconds. What are we looking at? I would be surprised if this reaction even gets out there, because when I first started the channel, I would use music in the background during my intros, and I still do, but I use stuff that I won't get copyrighted for now. The game, every single time I used one of his beats, I would get insta copyright. Dre, nothing. Eminem, nothing. Beastie Boys, nothing. The game, every fucking time, it was kind of a pattern, to be completely honest. So I don't know about the game. His hip hop never really turned me on or anything. I didn't enjoy his album. I thought he was very overrated. I thought the hype that came with him was completely unjustified. He was good. He was definitely above average, and he had a great flow. He had a great voice. He had a great story to tell. But I don't know, he came along like after 50 Cent was already sort of starting to lose a bit of his shine and his momentum, and it seemed like it was an attempt to do the same thing, and it just never really took off the same way. But let's see what the game's doing these days. Apparently he's talking shit about Eminem, so, and I'm a huge M fan, if you don't know that. I've reacted to a bunch of new Eminem stuff on this channel, and I was in one of his music videos, which was a tremendous honor. So Let's see what this song is all about.
Hey, Grandma. Yeah, I'm still out making my Uber runs. I'll be home soon. I just got one more pickup, kind of close to 8 Mile. Okay. Love you too.
What the fuck is this? So far the beat, I don't know what the fuck the deal with that intro was. Someone have to explain that to me in the comments. But the beat so far, I like it. It's old school, and I don't like the overly produced new beats. This sounds very traditional hip-hop style, so I'm digging the beat anyway.
I don't think they know who they fucking with. Pull that truck around, niggas is ducking clips.
I'm not that familiar with Eminem saying anything to game. Am I out of the loop on this? Is this the first attack?
16 paranoia filled days later.
I'm cool, man. You don't need that mask. Nobody cares about that shit anymore.
You got a charger up there with you?
Yeah, for sure. It reaches all the way back there, too.
Good looking, homie. Hey, yo, I really fuck with that starter cap. That shit hard as fuck.
Crazy story behind it. My brother Stan, rest in peace, what? He gave this hat 22 years ago.
Damn.
It's my favorite.
Can I see that shit for a minute?
Aw, don't give him the hat. What are you doing, man?
Oh, shit. This motherfucker autographed and everything. Who signed it for you?
Eminem. He used to be like this rap god.
Alright, so is this supposed to be, Stan's little brother? Didn't we already have him in Bad Guy? What's his name? Matthew Mitchell, bitch. I even have your initials. I remember that.
Man, me and my brother praised him. That's when I was little. I don't really like any of his new stuff.
Whoa, wait. I know where we're going. Wait, why do you have a
shit.
Hey, man, I'm driving. I'll get you there. Wait, I'll take you. I'm a fan. It's cool, too, man. You don't need to do this.
Focus on the fucking road.
Okay.
Yo, come on, man.
All right.
Drive.
All right.
Drive.
All I got is my word.
What the fuck? That is... Alright, we'll see where that story goes, but I don't know, man. I'm not trying to be biased or anything, but that was kind of lame. Like, what is happening with this? You're like mugging and kidnapping an Uber driver now because he doesn't like new Eminem shit? I'm confused at what that's supposed to be getting to.
My dick and my Mac 10. One thing you can never have is my motherfucking black... skin. This ain't no suit that I wore. This ain't a mansion of hanging black. This ain't no stupid award. So, oh, he goes platinum and oh, I'm on the map with him. He got all the blackest friends. He wants to be African me.
Okay.
Left for dead on the doctor's advocate. Dre never executive produced it. I just imagined it. Oh.
Okay, so this sounds like a really jealous, like, song, man. That's what I'm getting from this. So he's, like, jealous that Eminem and Dre are so fucking close with each other? Fucking hell, man.
Oh, here goes the magic tricks, candy shops and the magic stick. D'Angelo, baby, got in shape to whip your ass again. You depressed, you just masking it. You pop an Adderall, a Vicodin, and an aspirin. But the math wasn't mathin' it, so pass me the torch. Cause the torture in my mind, with the voice that defied rhymes, will force the blind eye to see that I was in the white Rolls Royce with 5'9s. When you was pretending to be the white Royce, the 5'9. I just crossed the fine line. Mike just forced the white guy to call D12 so he can be the pork that grinds swine.
I just forced the white guy to call D12 so he can be the pork they grind swine. Where has this come from, man? Where the fuck did this come from? Who hurt you, game? What is going on here? I like the line there. What was it? I see that I was in the white Rolls with the white Rolls Royce with 5'9s and you was pretending to be the white Royce to 5'9". I like the way that rhyme goes together, and there's no doubt about his lyrical capability and everything, but in terms of, like, what he's trying to convey, like, what? Like, Eminem came before you and changed the fucking industry, and then you showed up years later and had a moment and then sort of fizzled out, and you're... What point are you trying to make?
In the biggest rap in Detroit, that award is Sean Don. So uncork the Chardonnay and stick my fork in white wine. I never heard you in a club. I never heard you in a bar. 11 albums and 10 never got play inside of my car. I'd rather listen to Snitch 9 like 69 times than participate in 69s with 69 nuns than listen to you. You're a Karen, call the cops, tell him it's a black man on your block with a Glock and he got a cock. And the tattoos on his face is a star and a teardrop. He's standing on a teal drop and he says he can feel Pac in the air like Phil Collins. Listen to him, he's still wildin'. Ah, Epstein's chasing me around Epstein Island. So silence, I'm thinking, nothing rhymes with orange, so 50 Ficky Slim.
Okay, hang on a second. Like Phil Collins, listen to him, he's still wildin'. Epstein chased me around Epstein Island. So silence, I'm thinking, nothing rhymes with orange. Yeah, I mean, heaps of shit rhymes with orange. M already proved that, but maybe I'm just not following who he's trying to fucking go at this point.
Slim Shady, please stand up, shoot the fade with me, I love to put these hands up, I could 40 Glock you unarmed, drop the world on your head with one arm, this Slim Haley's with me, and she's unharmed for now.
God, I'm really scared.
These is the deepest secrets I keep, and I be on defense, cause G's ain't supposed to fold up with all the facades I hold up inside of my mind, I froze up.
Oh man, okay, hang on a second. I just got this like rush of anticipation for what the fuck Eminem is gonna do in response to this. What the fuck, man? You don't go after Haley. Didn't you fucking learn that when Machine Gun Kelly got fucking buried? And by the way, why is he saying any of this? What the fuck is going on? I'm gonna look it up at the end of this, like what the beef was anyway. Because I don't know where the fuck this has come from and why the game of all people thinks that he's got the fucking, you know, upper ground here.
It's COVID, Ebola, the Spanish flu and Corona, the Zika virus, pneumonia is deep inside my persona. On each side of my shoulders is demons chasing Jehovah, the renegade or the soldier. I really gave it to Jehovah. How I feel 23 years still ain't penetrating the culture. You...
Can I just say, he's saying how he doesn't listen to any of these songs, but he knows a fucking shitload about Eminem's fucking catalog.
You are not top five in mine, big or pot eyes. No Andre, no Nas. Stop telling white lies. Sniff a white line. This the right time. I Suge Knight, Vanilla Ice. I'm not Mr. Nice Guy. I'm crazy. I'm crazy. I'm not Mr. Nice Guy. I'm crazy.
Why does this song go for 10 fucking minutes?
Pissed off Jimmy, Universal, and Interscope. Nope, I got Jimmy, Slim, 50, and Universal, Interscope. Cause I'm shady. Shady.
That line was used on Killshot. Was it? You said you came to Interscope and you... Something about Interscope and you graze me, Interscope and Swayze or some shit like that. But I've heard that pretty much exact same rhyme.
Here than him, I'm crazy. crazier than Kim. So when the bat signal goes up and the clouds above the buildings, I hope you live long enough to see heroes turn into villains. Oh, you think I'm a joker? Well, riddle me this. You love your mother? Well, I'm cleaning out your closets for you and your half brother. And I told you when I was in Detroit, I wanted to go to 8 Mile. Cause when I was little to get some M&Ms, I had to walk 8 miles. But you wouldn't leave the studio. Your life is on loop. That's why I'm doggy in style. Cause niggas rather bump Snoop. And I'm a lyrical 50 cal. Leave his brains all thin when the game's all in. Then the chainsaw ring.
Again, so many Eminem references in this. It completely undoes him saying, I don't listen to any of those albums. So wait, he's pissed off that Eminem didn't want to go and get some fucking candy at the fucking store. No, I know he didn't want to go get, not talking about candy, but he's upset that Eminem didn't want to, like, leave the studio while he was making fucking music. Alright, well, that's why you are fucking nobody and Eminem went on to fucking do crazy fucking shit.
Ring. Hello? Hello? Paging Dr. Dre? He ain't got a lot to say, but since Curtis always do, let him write the rhymes for you. Tell him to clip the wings on my butterfly tat and force him back in the cocoon. And does he still rap? Or did he ever change your heart too? The chick on the show wasn't picking me and Mariah wasn't picking you. So the cannons is blam blam, and if it jammed, then I unjam it. And wipe down my stripper pole with the head grease from your bandana.
I actually really dig that line there. What the fuck is it? It would say the cannons are blam blam, and if it jammed, then I unjam it. I don't know, just a good little flow there. Is he trying to say that 50 Cent writes Eminem's lyrics? Shut the fuck up, game.
You wish you were Santana or Cam and them 10 J's. Do rag for 10 years and never had one wave. And I was that runaway slave that they buried in that one grave. And some say he will be back to haunt Slim Shady one day. Now I'm here, hope you're ready. This is not mom's spaghetti. This your dad was 22 when he ate Lil Debbie. He takes the cake because she was only 15. So how could one not sympathize with her having you as a teen? She had to lose herself in a moment.
Again, I have no idea what his fucking motivation is with this, but it seems really fucking just random and unnecessary. And you know what? He's not going in soft. He's definitely going in hard. That doesn't sound fucking right, but you get what I mean.
Give up her dreams just to see her son out here looking like a wigger in jeans. Little Marshall Mathers, mad cause nobody thinks that Little Marshall matters. That sentiment's hard to gather, let's get this shit all together. The picture was ripped, I fixed it, but none with me, you and 50. Let's stitch this shit all together, you like it Slim? I made it just for you. I even kidnapped Stan's brother and baited him here for you. But you'll just say no, probably leave us in the blistering cold. God made you damn near perfect, he just missed your soul. You ain't a shell of who you used to be. And after you, it's me on a Uzi spree like it's two of me. And Matthew's dead now. It's just you and me, the sweatpants, the dad hat, do-rag, and no jewelry.
By the way, I'm just gonna cut out, like, the entire first verse of this song because it was fucking shit. The last two or three have been where the meat is, but this is fucking unreal, man. This is like Will Smith slapping Chris Rock. Like, what happened? Why did you do this? Why are you so angry? Why is he your target? Like, give me a little bit of fucking, what the fuck, man?
Is that cultural appropriation? Ask Paul if it's even appropriate for me to make that statement. Rude to me, how your date went? Did you re-dye your beard or get another facelift or do shrooms in your mom's basement until you nod and see spaceships and the aliens inside it come and tell you your talent's wasted? Then you wake up and you ain't shit. I know you fiending for a Dr. Dre bass hit. How ironic. And add it in the basement. And now I chronic because I didn't had it with the fake shit. You never understood Ebonics or Cadence. I press everything like a weight bench. And every time the plate hits, you offer another playlist. Sorry, it ain't working out.
He's really trying to fucking, like, get inside Eminem's head. You would never understood Ebonics or a cadence. Like, if you want to, like, sort of fuck with, like, a person's, like, speech pattern and stuff like that, I feel like M would be someone that would be not necessarily sensitive to it, but aware of things like cadence. And it's like one of the things where if you, like, say to somebody, like, nice hair, and you don't give it any context, like, it's just gonna kind of stick in their head. And yeah, man, like, this is a nasty fucking piece of work.
Now, niggas shooting Billy Blaze. It's my winning speech. While I'm here, I should really thank MGK, UGK, Tech 9, Uzi Spray. My other 12 personalities wasn't really in the mood today. Hi kids, here's some fun. Let's all say nigga once. Crashed the car, hit and run. Jumped out, hit the gun. Your fans want a rap guy, well fuck it, I'ma give him one. I came to put Slim in the box, but he already living one.
Mr. Shady, don't be shady. Pick that pin.
Why has he got so many different choruses in this fucking song? Alright, game. So what, he thinks Eminem's a sellout. That's what I'm getting from this. He doesn't leave the house. Man, Eminem is at that fucking ridiculous level of fame where you can't really go anywhere and do anything. And I don't know, man, like, I don't know what that's like, and I can't fucking criticize the guy for making that decision. As long as he doesn't turn into a fucking weirdo like Michael Jackson, then hey, that's his fucking business. Did we get any fucking shots taken on the outro? Tell you what, he had a lot of fucking shit to say throughout this song. He got a lot off his chest. This must have been very cathartic for the game. Huh. Well, game, you just fucking ignited a fucking response, I'm sure. Wow, going in on his, like, mum getting pregnant when she was only 15, and his fucking talking about Haley, and talking about how he was addicted, and racial appropriation, and all that kind of shit. That was a pretty heavy fucking song. It was needlessly long. He had a lot to say, but I feel like you could have fit that into, like, a 6-minute track if you took out the kind of shitty choruses, but lyrically, it was fucking brutal. That is a hell of a fucking diss track. If I'm speaking unbiasedly as somebody just observing this from pure musical standpoint, that was a fucking amazing song and a great diss track. A great way to initiate a rap feud, that's for sure. Looking at it as a human being with my own moral compass and things like that, what the fuck is he talking about? Why the fuck is he saying this shit? Why has he gone in so hard? I need fucking answers. Let's fucking Google this shit. What's going on here? Why is the game mad at Eminem? Whoa. Hang on. The game says this isn't him? What the fuck is going on? Was this the game or not? What the... The game's just dramatic. Alright, hang on. No Life Shaq's talking about this. What's going on in the comments on his video? Maybe it actually was him. I don't know. All right, either way, whoever the fuck that was, it was a very entertaining song. It was a very fucking insulting song, an incredibly personal song as well. And hey, all is fair in love and rap battles, I guess. But, woof, yeah, I'm very curious to see what the fallout is from this. Let me know in the comments what you guys thought about this. Is it the game? Please comment if anything gets confirmed. Because it sounded like him, but I don't know if he was trying to, like, do like an homage to Eminem, or if he was like, if it's somebody else doing his voice now. So I don't know what the fuck's going on. Very entertaining listen. Can't wait to see what M's got to say in response. And as always, everyone, be well, stay safe, look after your friends. See you in the next video. Peace.